Tell them the doctor said to say hi. In fact, we'd like to say hi to Roy Story right now. Any higher and I could be playing with the 76ers.
That's right.
Oh. I wish I could do that.
Well, if you're hungry for baseball insight, read today's column by Tom Weir on the USA Today sports page. Very, very interesting and very good. Democrats
good morning.
And the Oakland A's are coming in common. Yesterday,
oh, that's my bag.
You have a chance to look
time. Let me tell you about the weather this morning, which is, can I say it up in one word? Beautiful.
Wow.
Now, that's how nice the weather is today. And I say that because, well, you know, a week ago we were having those tremendous rains and everything. And today, look at here, it's going to go all the way into the low 70s. We could even set a record. It's 56 degrees this morning at the Big C on KISS, AM and PM. Not to mention AM and FM. A little chopped liver on the side this morning. And a little. That's the way it always is when you're waking yourself in the morning, right? Friday night is date night for so many folks. And what is it you say right before it happens?
Yeah.
Nice and tight.
Yeah, well, of course.
Gosh, Ross is really doing well.
Yeah, love it. Love me. Love my rock and roll. At 8:58, it's a couple minutes before 9 o'clock. And Dr. Don Rose, we'll have a special guest this morning. Jerry Stewart is going to be interviewing whose sisters?
The Byrne sisters.
The Byrne sisters. And you hear them on KISS, so that'll be interesting. What else is going on? Oh, Oakley news. We always give Oakley news on the program. And it's just come to our attention that last Christmas they arrested a guy for impersonating Santa Claus in Oakland. Oh, and if you're interested in buying a milk cow, there's one advertised in the Oakley paper this morning, owned by a little old lady with suede gloves.
Advanced paging, professionalism. Advanced paging, superior service.
Walnut Creek Toyota.
Well, we gave a great night on the town just a few minutes ago. Stick around. Next hour, we're giving away a trip for tea to Tahuti.
KKIS, 990 AM, Pittsburgh, Concord. KKIS FM 92, Walnut Creek.
You want the best? KISS. KKIS.
KISS News Time 901, major breakthrough in Alzheimer's. Right now in Concord, it's 59 degrees and heading on up at the all new KISS AM and FM.
Yep.
KISS News Time 903.
And now the pretty girl is like a melody, and she'll be around in an hour.
Yes.
In the meantime, of course, it's who?
It's who? KISS News Time 903. I'll have more at bottom of the hour, and now Dr. Don Rose.
Kids are so pampered these days. When I was a kid at lunchtime, I had two choices: take it or leave it.
D. Rose, 9:07, 7 minutes after 9 o'clock, and got a great phone call from a lady named Tara Stoffergen, and she wanted to say hi. Is that an interesting name, Stoffergen? Sounds like it might be Finnish, and the reason I mention that is because I spent 5 years in Duluth, Minnesota. She grew up in Duluth, Minnesota, and all of a sudden put it together just today. Hey, this is the same guy that I used to listen to, and that was Tara, that was 61 to 66, remember? Duluth, Minnesota. I remember the first time I walked out of our hotel and there was a dog frozen to a wheel of a car. One day the wind stopped blowing in Duluth and everybody fell over. Ah, those were the days. And this morning at 10 o'clock, the doctor is going to make a quick exit from here and head into San Francisco for the Bill Gavin Convention. I was a Bill Gavin correspondent in those years, 61 to 66 in Duluth, reporting faithfully all of the songs that were big in Duluth, Minnesota. And I guess a big seller there, my wife, so 25, 30 copies. Anyway, we checked out all of the record stores every week, and it was great. And Bill Gavin has passed on to that great radio station in the sky, where I'm sure he's music director these days. But the other guys that are still there, throwing a great convention, and there'll be radio people from not only America, but all around the world there today. In the meantime, of course, it'll be Jerry Stewart here at KISS. I don't know if you knew this, but for 2 years, Jerry dated a midget and didn't even know it. She just thought he was humble. Oh, and how about the time Jerry went to an A's game? The usher asked her to stop singing. She was throwing the crowd off key. Jerry wanted to join the FBI, but she wasn't big enough to carry the safe. Then she decided to join the Naval Air Force, but she wasn't too sure about forcing air through her navel.
I'd like to talk to you about the Northern California Heart and Lung Institute.